tell that C. Ooh. Trying to the LMPD. Go and get yourself esteem. It's your trying to link up. So much we got synced up. Put up in the dinged up whip. This ain't Pepto Biz. What this pink stuff is. Go and tell me. Yeah, you heard me. You ain't feel me. I've been moving. I've been shaking. Go and hit me on the celly. Try to sell me on something while I hold it. Compelling. Ever since I've been gone like Kelly. They've been trying to tell me about this and that. I ain't chatting with you. We ain't going tit for tat. Trying to tell me how to get in the bag. We're going to get in the bag. I'm about to get in the bag. Automatic is a habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chicks, she don't know that I can pace it. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put $100 out of savings. I can tell now that you ain't talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down front. I'm gonna pull it with the bar down one. 6 months saying I ain't once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that C.
Inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome here in New Orleans. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tennessee Titans and the New Orleans Saints.
Brandon McManus set to kick off.
The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. Taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing, Mayfield, and the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. Given 9 there on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. The Saints first down there on a gain of 11. And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
There's a throw. The ball is taken in by his tight end. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
Makes it third and eight.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Mayfield down. That is Thomas. It's a touchdown for the Ravens. Michael Thomas, his second touchdown on the season. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Lux with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game.
Will Lux to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lux to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Ezekiel Elliott, and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And that'll be incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
He's got his man. Tyler Boyd, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Brandon McManus set to kick off.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fielded in the end zone. Dances by him. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock them out.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. That's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's fourth down.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, 4 on the return, and it'll be Titan football. The first half update now from Philadelphia, and the Eagles out in front early. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. They'll start the drive with Elliott, and very little daylight there. They'll get a couple up to the 44.
Ezekiel. Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30.
Complete.
So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line in gate.
Trying for Brown. It's intercepted. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 20. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see plays unfold and make their own plays. But you also have to have good feel as well, because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold, feel what's going on, and then get to the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
A throw for Boyd, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
It's good, and it is now 21-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a three-yard gain there. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
It's a gain of a yard, and it's third down.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. Picked up by Marshawn Lattimore. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Intercepted. The Saints take over first and 10.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Now a handoff looking right. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. A pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score.
21, Titans 7.
From the 24, Mayfield steps away to his left. He's got the first down inside the 10, and he'll be out of bounds. Turns out to be a great idea to tuck that one. Good for 24 yards.
First down and goal to go.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. He knocks it through. It's 28-7.
Makes the score Saints 28, Titans 7. Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're down three touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. Elliott gonna bite off about 7 on that one. A good run on first down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and 3. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. That'll be taken in there by Miles Boykin. Territory. Wow, first and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. Touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Titans are able to close the gap just a bit. It's up and good, and it's now 28-14.
The score, Saints 28, Titans 14.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
At the 20-yard line.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Field. But the man is the tight end Trautman. And they let this well upfield across the 45. 27 yards there. First down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. And he didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
They run the counter now on first down. He'll get 3 up to midfield.
3, the ball carrier.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation. An easy conversion on the first down.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
3-yard line.
Mayfield on first down. Flushed out right. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. And they'll employ the jumbo set now on second and 1. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16.
He's brought down.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Now they try the right side here. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9. And they need 10 yards out of it on third. Mayfield on play action. This will be caught at about the 6. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Titans 14. Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Titans first down.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Boyd. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Back to Brown, this time complete. Touchdown, Titans! A.J. Brown, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in a second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Saints take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker room and then try and add to it in the second half. But there's a part of me that looks at this and says, first half going my way, I have a little bit of a cushion. Let's go ahead and try and extend things. If you've got some good plays drawn up, you might want to think about them right here.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Alert!
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trip to the opposite side. And all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. He'll get this to his tight end, Troutman. And he'll go out near midfield. The 49, 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
22 more yards.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Looking long for Thomas. This is caught inside the 15. Take it in the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Michael Thomas. In the final seconds of the first half, and the Saints add on to their lead. Lutz good on the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach?
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And these guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
The Saints take over first and 10.
A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. From the gun, Mayfield. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The Titans going to get the ball to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back to it on EA Sports. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And they get 17 more on that one and another first down.
It's a gain of 17 yards. And the Titans, first down.
Elliott on first down, going to get this back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. Defense able to get there, swarm to the football, zilch, zero, nada there for the offense, Charles.
Yeah, it really was an example of good team defense, wasn't it? Everyone handled their responsibilities, and they held them to no gain.
Again, he'll drop the throw. Escaping the pressure right. And that's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And that is incomplete.
The scoreboard tells the story for him, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They'll look to throw again. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone, possibly get
a breakaway from Michael Thomas. The 30, past the 20. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play there. Catch and run, 78 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. But it'll be second and goal. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action, maybe throwing it.
And this Tennessee defense for the second straight play gets him behind the line. They're not messing around. Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
Thank you.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
A gain of a yard.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time.
And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, and you knock up too many attempts shorter than that one. I don't think anyone got a finger on it. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
Complete.
A good pickup there, 21 yards.
A gain of 21.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Quadre Diggs there defensively.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Now a deep throw there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, but now it'll be third down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Back to throw again. And this is incomplete.
The pass.
You tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Glad to be in the great city of New Orleans, rolling along here in the third quarter, second and 10. Forced out to his left. Going deep for Eifert. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
They figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it, and the Saints will have the football back. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
Right back to him on first down. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A full five-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough. On second and 15 now. Mayfield in a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
First and 10.
They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
And the Titans first down.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Going deep for Eifert. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Titans. Tyler Eifert. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Titans are able to close the gap just a bit. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Fielded in the end zone. Get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Their lead down from 21 to 14, but still sitting in a great spot, up two scores here in the third quarter. He'll air it out. That's caught at the 25. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. His third touchdown of the game and fourth on the year. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz will look to add the extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns and 21 points.
The score is Saints 49. Titans 28. Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Tyler Boyd, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Looking deep for Elliott. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. And give him a gain of 37.
Down Titan.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
For A.J. Brown, incomplete. It leads to second and 10.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Elliott. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 20-yard line. Back now here live in New Orleans. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! A.J. Brown with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit. And the lead will be cut down to 14.
Makes the score Saints 49, Titans 30.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
At their own 16-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. If they can score here, they have a chance to make this a three-possession game and all but put things to bed.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. They call it a pickup of seven, and it'll make it a second down.
Brings up seven.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. A handoff as they run the counter play. The 35. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks.
And it's caught inside the 30. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints. Touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints now add six to their lead. And the lead now to three touchdowns and 21 points.
Makes the score Saints 56, Titans 31.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. No return on this one as the fair catch is single four and taken.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one. They'll probably...
And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Sheldon Rankins abruptly ends that play with a sack. Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they had planned for second and 23. Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. And he'll be just shy of the 20 at the 19 as he goes out of bounds. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
And it's third down.
Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Fourth down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
First down, Tennessee.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Boyd. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. So in Saints territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 25. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him, let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Brings up second.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. A handoff is a little catapult. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. It's picked up by the Titans. And they're going to bring this one back. A fumble return touchdown for the Titans.
Brandon McManus.
So hold the phone here, Charles. I've kind of written them off, but after that touchdown, certainly a long way still to go, but stranger things have happened.
Well, when you're going to have big second half comebacks, plays like that have to be involved.
McManus's point after is good, and the lead will be cut down to 14. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Saints take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They have to like the position that they are in. Fourth quarter, two-score lead, and now the ball back after the INT. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 19-yard line.
Second down, Mayfield. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Brings up third down and 10.
The Saints on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is third and 10. Play fake, Mayfield. Got him in, he finds Sanders. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
And at the 40-yard line.
On first and 10, Mayfield. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Across midfield inside the 45. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. A much better effort we're seeing from him under center this week versus last week when he threw 4 picks.
He has thrown the one in this game, but you're right. When you come down from 4 the previous week, and we always talk about adjustments, well, he made some in practice, and he continues to work on it during the game. I'm sure he's getting plenty of reminders about how to stay in the moment, stay focused on the task.
And he's got him in the driver's seat here in the fourth quarter. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 25-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Saints add on to their lead. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21 points.
Wins the score, Saints 63, Titans 42.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for 5.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 46. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got it.
Looking for Thomas, he's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, 27 yards. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for six. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Sheldon Rankins able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's caught inside the 35. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. J. Brown, 82 yards. And the Titans are able to close the gap just a bit.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Extra point from McManus is good, and that'll cut the lead back down to 21.
Set to kick off.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is
if they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show.
Playing the catch. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for New Orleans,